இட்ஸ் அ ஜாப்பனீஸ் டேர்ம். ரே மீன்ஸ் யூனிவர்சல் எனர்ஜி, கே மீன்ஸ் லைஃப் ஃபோர்ஸ் எனர்ஜி. ரே யூனிவர்சல் எனர்ஜி மீன்ஸ் வாட் இஸ் அவுட் சைட். திஸ் அப்பியர்ஸ் ஆஸ் எ மியர் வேக்கன்ட் ஸ்பேஸ். திஸ் இஸ் ஃபில்ட் ஒன்லி வித் எனார்மஸ் அமௌண்ட் ஆஃப் காஸ்மிக் எனர்ஜி கிரியேட்டட் பை தி சுப்ரீம் சோல். வாட் இஸ் ப்ரெசன்ட் ஹியர், வி ஆர் பிரீதிங் ஆல் தி 24 hours. ஒன்ஸ் இட் கோஸ் இன்சைட் அஸ், இட் கீப்ஸ் அஸ் அலைவ். நாட் ஓன்லி அலைவ், இட் இஸ் ஆல்சோ கீப்பிங் அஸ் ஹெல்த்தி. ஃபார் சர்வைவல் அண்ட் ஹெல்த், தி எனர்ஜி விச் யூ ஆர் பிரீதிங் இஸ் அப்சல்யூட்லி எசென்ஷியல். தி எனர்ஜி இட் இஸ் நாட் ஏர் வித் ஆக்சிஜன் ஆஸ் இட் இஸ் பீங் டோல்ட் பை மாடர்ன் சயின்டிஸ்ட். இட் இஸ் டிவைன் எனர்ஜி கிரியேட்டட் பை காட். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் ரே யூனிவர்சல் எனர்ஜி. கீ மீன்ஸ் தி எனர்ஜி விச் இஸ் விதின் அஸ். ஹீலிங் இஸ் டன் பை channelizing the cosmic energy. We just bring the cosmic energy into our system and then channelize this energy to the person in need, the sick person, through the chakras and next. So you must know what is body. Modern science is limited only to the physical body because it is visible to the naked eye, but invisible force is there around all of us. We are born with this energy that is called auric body or biomagnetic field. So this is the physical body visible to the naked eye, but around this we have got auric body that is called biomagnetic field, in which chakras are present. The 7 chakras are essential, or the knowledge of the 7 chakra mandatory for learning Reiki. The source of energy, this is a physical body. The source of energy is the cosmic energy. It comes to the, it enters the chakra and then reaches the physical body. See, this is the, these are the organs that are present within the body, supplied by the central nervous system and autonomic nervous system. This can be seen even in the dead body. This is the body with all the components in a particular area supplied by the nervous system. Okay, but this doesn't have life. What is the source of life? This is the energy body with which we are born. We have the energy body, but it is invisible force. Just as we are breathing the air which is not visible to the naked eye, we have an invisible force around all of us. This is the source of energy. What is present in the center is only mere body. Mere body doesn't have life, but this is the life. This life, which we call as the auric body, it is in 7 layers. Just like rainbow has got 7 layers, 7 colors, this also, aura also is in 7 layers. The outermost one is called, that is the outer limit of our body. This is the outer limit of our body. This is in the violet color, then indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange. What is that you recall? What you have studied in high school, that is rainbow has got 7 colors. This indicates that we are part of nature. What is there in nature, it is there within us also. This is our body. It is not this body, this is the body. Body is only here. This is the energy. Without this, nobody can survive. This is the source of energy. The once the person is dead, there is no invisible force at all. Only the body. That is why it is taken to the cremation ground. And these 7 chakras are present. So this is the, I am going to explain about this later on, but this is the physical body in which chakras are present. This is a body visible to the naked eye, in which through openings are there, which we call as nostrils, through which we are supposed to take the air. This is supposed to give us life, but this is not the only one. This is visible to the naked eye. That is why modern scientists have told we are breathing through the air. We are not breathing only through the air. This is the auric body in which 7 major chakras are present. Each major chakra has got, it actually acts as a energy center. We are breathing throughout our life through these energy centers only. Through this nostrils alone we are not breathing. We are breathing all the 24 hours, or from life to death we are breathing only through the chakras. Without this we cannot exist. So this is the source of energy, but from cosmos it energy passes through the auric body. It is concentrating on the chakras level, then it is just transferred into the endocrine organ, which are present within the physical body. all of us, the modern scientists have got enough and more knowledge about the endocrine organs because they are visible to the naked eye. But these endocrine organs are supposed to bring harmony among us. Hormonal balancing. But hormonal balancing, how does it take place? It is because of the balancing of the chakras. Chakras are outside the physical body, endocrine organs are within the physical body. Each chakra is related to one endocrine organ. About this, the knowledge of this will be told, knowledge of this is actually mandatory for learning Reiki. Without the knowledge of chakra, without the knowledge of endocrine gland, nobody can perform healing or nobody can heal others. Stuck up or there? He is sleeping. See, how do we heal? We are bringing the cosmic energy into our system, auric body, chakra, fill up our body. You go on healing others, number of people, you get more energy. Then that energy which is filling up our auric body, chakra and physical body comes externally through the aura, through the chakra which is in the hand, palm chakra. So this is the hand which acts as a tool for healing self and others. So this knowledge is available. When you come to the class, you will be told about the auric body, chakra, endocrine organs. Scientifically we are explaining everything. It is not the chakra alone. Chakras are outside. How they are related to endocrine organs. All these things you will learn once you learn Reiki. Scanning. How do we go for? Why I am just talking about this? You must know the benefits of Reiki. What it can do for you. How it can help others. How it can help you also. Scanning. We don't have scanning machine. Absolutely no diagnostic test. Absolutely no machine. Absolutely no medicine. No medicine, no test. That is the fundamental principle of Reiki. What is the scanning? We don't have any scanning machine. The hand is the only tool for scanning the person, scanning the chakra. Chakra is responsible for receiving the energy. If one chakra doesn't function properly, we call this one as the malfunctioning of the chakra. If one chakra doesn't function properly, immediately the endocrine organ which is present within will not function properly. Then the modern scientists say hormonal imbalance. We say chakra imbalance. We balance the, we actually when a person comes, we just bring about balancing of the chakra, automatically hormonal balancing takes place, automatically energy, the recovery takes place. I have told you, I am not sending any patients to any test. As far as I am concerned, I have not tested. From 93 onwards, I have been practicing. I have not sent any of my patients to any laboratory test, nor I have given any prescribed medicine, nor I have suggested, I have not asked somebody to go to someone such as a doctor, take this medicine. Never. Once they come, they are exhausting all resources. Finally, how I diagnose? I make the person talk. Only the patient can talk. If I have the patient, if I have stomach pain, I can only say about my problem. Then I say, I got the pain here. It gets aggravated in the evening or after taking food, I just get more pain. All these things only I can explain. That is, patient only can talk about his problem. Machines cannot diagnose. Machines cannot find out how long the patient is having the problem, when it started, when it gets a, no machine can diagnose. So I make the person talk about his experience. Each person is his own doctor or her own doctor. Then when I make the patient talk, she starts talking about the her own problem, when it started, how it started, all these things the person will be able to talk. I will just no diagnostic test. I'll give you a simple example. Yesterday one person came, one couple, the wife is my student, husband happens to come regularly for taking treatment. When he felt some sickness, he is a workaholic, doesn't have any break at all, so suddenly he felt some uneasiness. When he felt the uneasiness, immediately the wife just got worried. she immediately rushed, she was taken to the hospital, nearby hospital, famous hospital. They actually conducted all the tests, exhausted. Finally, they said, nothing wrong with you. Probably you may have to go to psychiatrist. Fortunately, that man has got lot of confidence in me. While going to the hospital, he called me. Then I said, I did Reiki healing, distant healing. Wife also knows, I told her how she should. But when yesterday he came, after getting discharged, he came to me. Then I asked him, what is the problem? Then he said, I felt as if my heart stopped for a few seconds. Then I said, how did you know your heart stopped? You are alive. No, I felt like this. Then I started jumping from like this. Then I thought by jumping, my heart would just revive. This is what he was explaining. By jump up and down, he thought he could revive his heart. Then same thing he went and told the doctor. Doctor examined him thoroughly, including ECG, etc., etc. I do not know what all the test. Finally, when he came, I said, first, let's try to relax. Then I actually, removed all the negative energy and I made him relax. When a person comes to us, when they are actually going through the relaxation technique, or we just do what is called healing. But when the person goes out of my clinic, he says, I am relaxed. What happens when you go to the hospital? They examine you thoroughly, then they just identify some problem. You have got BP, you have got diabetes, you have got disc prolapse. Finally, he goes with that idea in his mind. He possesses the disease. I have diabetes, I have BP, I have disc prolapse, all these things he possesses, he will never come out of it. Here, when the person comes for Reiki treatment, he is allowed to relax. The mind relaxes. Where is the mind? It is in the auric body. In the auric body. So, once the mind relaxes, automatically body relaxes, recovery takes place. So, there is absolutely no necessity for any diagnostic. Patients can talk about himself, and when the patient talks about himself, when it gets aggravated, we diagnose by scanning and making the person talk, then we proceed with the treatment. Meditation forms the foundation for Reiki. Without meditation, there is no Reiki at all. Because some people are coming to me. Even last week, one lady came from Calcutta. She had some problem. She has already learned Reiki. But I asked her, when you have learned Reiki, why don't you help yourself? Then I asked her to go for daily start meditating. Then I asked her to do certain things, keep her hand on certain chakras, etc. Then she said she has not taught anything about Reiki meditation. Meditation is a unique meditation taught in Reiki that forms the foundation. Once they learn Reiki meditation, it forms part and parcel of our life. Just like yourself taking baths, yourself taking food for 10-15 minutes, this forms the part of your life. But this is a unique meditation where you are not having a picture of God or anything like that. Just close your eyes, concentrate on the third eye, which you think only Lord Shiva has got. All of us are born with the third eye. We are concentrating on the energy that comes from outside, then concentrate on the energy that goes inside. That is the unique way of doing meditation. It is not only in Reiki. How we are doing this one? See, first of all, for a person to breathe, he must be alive. Only when a person is alive, he can breathe. So, from where do you get the energy to be alive? For survival, that comes from the what is called Mooladhara Chakra or Root Chakra. So, there is a chakra called Root Chakra which is facing down. That draws maximum amount of energy from the mother earth. We think only plants have got root, all of us also have got root. That root exists between the Mooladhara Chakra and the mother earth. We draw the energy from the mother earth. Once the mother earth gives energy to us, we are alive. That is why it is also called as a root chakra. Then once the person, when you are alive, when the person is alive, he has to breathe. Only when a person breathes, he is supposed to be alive. But for a person to be able to breathe, he must have life. So this is the source of energy for our survival. Then he starts breathing. How does he breathe? From cosmos. From cosmos, from heaven, he takes the energy that comes through the, that actually is captured by Sahasrara chakra, which is facing heaven. So we have got two sources of energy. To be alive, we connect ourselves to the Mother Earth. The root exists between the Mooladhara chakra and the Mother Earth. Once the person is alive, take the energy by breathing. That energy which comes from by breathing is coming from heaven. It is actually captured, it passes through the Sahasrara chakra. So two sources of energy. We are between heaven and earth. From both the sources, we are drawing the energy through meditation. This is what we are teaching. Then once the person draws the energy from heaven and earth, mind, where is the mind? It is outside the physical body. It is in the aura, in the chakras, and the, all the chakras are in the auric body. Once these source of two sources of energy reach the physical body, reach the chakra and the physical body starts relaxing. Energy comes from two sources. First, mind relaxes. Then we allow the energy to pass through our all the other chakras. That is a unique meditation. First we concentrate on the Mooladhara chakra. Then ask the patient to concentrate on the white light coming from the heaven. Then allow this energy to concentrate in the physical body. Then allow this energy to allow the energy from cosmos through the other chakras also, one by one. Agni chakra, the energy comes, reaches the chakra one by one. All the seven major chakras are receiving the energy while meditating without your knowledge. You close the eyes, concentrate only on your chakra. There is, you don't have to go to the temple. You don't have to have a picture of God. You concentrate on your own self. That is, the chakras are available. God, Lord Shiva has got only one chakra. We have been brought to this world by God. Our parents want us to be better than those people. I was given education because my father wanted me to be better than him. So similarly, the Creator has created us. He has got only one chakra, but we have got seven chakras. He says, I have given seven chakras. Don't come and knock at my door whenever you have got problem. These seven chakras are responsible for our health. So through these seven chakras only we are drawing the energy. All the seven chakras are just receiving the energy. They are opening up. Then once they open up, the mind which is outside the physical body starts relaxing. Once the mind relaxes, physical body receives the energy, the entire physical body relaxes. So mind relaxes, physical body also relaxes in the meditation. This is a unique meditation which wherever you want you can do. You need not do it only in the early morning Brahma Muhurtam, even at this time, the afternoon. But only thing is, even if you are in big crowd, thousands of people, you can isolate yourself and start meditating, because you are meditating on your own self. So the sound etc. outside is not good, will not disturb you at all. This is how we meditate on our own. First we concentrate on Mooladhara chakra, drink the energy from heaven. Both the energy concentrate on the auric body chakra and also physical body. Then the mind and physical body relax. This is the unique way of meditation. This is what is being taught in the Reiki class. Advantages or benefits of Reiki. Because the person has to spend huge amount for diagnosis itself. Once you fall sick, you have the tendency to go to the best hospital. Immediately you are admitted in as a patient, or you will be taken to ICU. Then all the tests will be conducted. For conducting tests itself, you have to spend a huge amount. Then you will be given some medicine. Whether the diagnosis is correct or not, whether the root cause is known or not, medicines are prescribed. So medicine is not required. The moment a person comes to us, when a patient approaches me, I just allow the person to talk about himself. Within 5 minutes, I know which chakra is affected. One chakra is not independent of the other. All the 7 major chakras should be in harmony. If one chakra doesn't function properly, the other chakras also will not function properly. That's what I told. So, if one chakra, if the person has got some problem here, that means this chakra, which is called Anahata chakra, is not functioning properly. So, we don't treat only this chakra as it is being done in allopathy. For each organ, there is a specialist. Here, specialist is there, he sends enormous amount of cosmic energy which has got the healing power. So, we don't concentrate first day, second day, third day, we don't treat only one particular chakra. Though we know pretty well only that particular chakra is affected, we remove the negative energy which blocks the flow of energy, then the other chakras are also brought into harmony. All the 7 major chakras, when they are brought into harmony, the person automatically recovers. So, the Reiki is very, very economical. First day itself, diagnosis done. First day itself, treatment also has started. Time is saved, money also is saved. That is cost effective. Absolutely, there is no medicine in this world without any side effect. Can anyone name any medicine? Doctor also is here. Can you name any medicine without any side effect? Any medicine. All medicines have got their own side effects. Some of them, they go without even prescription, they buy Prozin. They simply swallow for fever, pain, etc. But it is hepatotoxic. It damages the liver. But they do not know. After some time, once the liver is damaged, further test, further medicine, all these things. Once they do not, if they do not know what is the problem, steroids is being pumped into the body. So this is no, the side effects. If you go on taking medicine for a pretty long time, the medicine effect, toxic materials accumulate in your body, it gives rise to some other cumulative effects will be more. Then sometimes when you take some medicine, it may produce new diseases. We come across several diseases now. Dengue, swine flu, avian flu, all these flus, cerebral spinal, encephalitis, all of them are the root cause for all these things, virus. For any particular virus, it is not possible to produce, say for example, cold. Now they say we have got vaccine for cold. It is not possible for any manufacturer to prepare a vaccine for cold, because it is made up of, it is because of virus. Virus, if the vaccine is given, what happens if your immune system is not functioning properly, in an unconducive atmosphere, instead of protecting the baby, protecting the person who is taking the vaccine, the virus may mutate, give rise to some other disease. So this is likely to happen. Instead of protecting the person, it may give rise to new disease. That is why so many flus are there, swine flu, dengue, this, that and all. Sometimes if they are not able to find out, mysterious disease, we do not know. Some people are admitted, some people, their pocket in one area, so many persons are admitted, if they are suffering from mysterious disease, because they do not identify the root cause. So these are all coming under the category of iatrogenic diseases. Some people come with diabetes, cancer, BP or some other problem. But when they come with this problem, chronic cases like cancer, diabetes, I never ask them to stop taking the medicine. There are some Reiki masters or acupuncturists, they say, once you stop taking the medicine, then only I'll proceed with the treatment. It is not happening, because the side effects will be more, or withdrawal syndrome will be more. If the person is taking medicine for a pretty long time, if I ask the patient to stop taking the medicine, just like alcohol, cannot stop all of a sudden, just withdrawal syndrome will be more. So I don't ask the patient to stop taking the medicine. So they will continue. Only thing is, how it can continue, no? This is not interfering with the allopathy, Ayurveda, homeopathy, or any other pathy. The people come to us after exhausting all these type of therapy for empathy or sympathy. Because by that time, the disease would have taken a deep root. So it may take pretty long time, but I cannot just say it can take long time. Miracles happen. Those who are associated with me, who are practicing with me now, for the past 2 or 3 months, some students have been trained by me, they are with me. They see how I diagnose, how miracles are happening. We, first day itself, they feel some relief. That is the miracle. Miracle cannot be performed by you and me. We are ordinary human beings. We have got our own limitation. The cosmic energy can perform. How cosmic energy can perform? It is because of the Supreme Soul. He is number one physician, number one surgeon. He is sending the energy. That energy knows the root cause of the problem. Once the root cause of the problem is relieved, automatically the symptom is relieved. Here, not only we are healing the person who are coming physically, we do what is called distant healing also. Sometimes through Skype also I do distant healing, or in emergency over the phone I can heal person. So Reiki reaches, once the root cause is removed, automatically symptom just vanishes. Here we are not treating the particular chakra. Whole body is a single unit. We treat the entire body without any drugs. Because the energy reaches the physical level, emotional level, mental level and spiritual level. Why Reiki? Unlike allopathy, they carry the disease when they go out. They actually go out of the clinic or go out of the hospital. But here they come with the disease, then they go out, the mind is relaxed, physical body also is relaxed. So it relaxes the body. Body is only this one. But as long as the energy is blocked, what is health? Uninterrupted flow of energy through the auric body, through the chakra, finally the physical body takes the energy. Physical body is the last one to show the symptom. But if there is any anxiety, if there is any stress, if there is sadness, excessive sadness, this will block the flow of energy. The auric body shows the symptom. Patient feels the symptom, then medicine machines cannot diagnose. That is why I told you, yesterday one person went, he was subjected to all the tests. Finally they said, you are absolutely normal, there is nothing wrong with you. Why should a person say, I have got some problem, and why should he get admitted in the hospital and spend time? He is not a fool to do that. Something he felt, what he felt was there in the auric body, in the chakra. That is why machines cannot identify. That is why I also do not trust the machine. Machines cannot diagnose certain things. What is there in the mind? What is there in the chakra? What is there in the auric body? Cannot be diagnosed by the machines at all. Only when the physical body shows the symptom, sometimes the machines can diagnose, sometimes machines also give a wrong picture. Relaxes both mind and body. Chakras are responsible for maintaining. All the 7 chakras should be in harmony, then only you are supposed to be in health. As a healer, what is the difference between me and an ordinary person? I am also, I have got my own limit. I am not telling I am a healer. Healer is number one physician who is sitting there. I am an ordinary human being, just like learning maths, physics, chemistry. I learned this subject, Reiki, then I have mastered the subject. See, you go through the high school, then you get 1 degree, then you do for teacher training, there is one degree called B.Ed or M.Ed. Go through that, then you become a teacher. So I am a teacher who has learned this ancient science. This is not the modern science. Modern science has got its own limitation. This is our science, ancient science. The ancient science talks about the existence of the cosmic energy, the existence of the same energy in your body, and that there is, you are always communicating with the cosmic energy. This actually was recorded or was was actually experienced by our saints. The olden days, the saints had the knowledge. They didn't, even before the medical college came, even before the medicine, modern medicine came into India, all these were existing. They experienced they knew what is the composition of the body, what are the organs that are placed, how to heal this without this one. Healing only by touch. Touching what? Touching the auric body, touching the chakra. You don't have to touch the physical body at all. That is the unique feature of Reiki. You don't have to ask the patient to remove the clothes. You don't have to examine the physical body at all. Ask the patient to talk, then you know which chakra is affected. You go only to the chakra. You need not have thorough knowledge of biology. I am basically an anatomist. But when I come to this, I am not an anatomist. I am only a tool for the Supreme Soul. I am just use my hand to channelize the cosmic energy into the person in need. You can heal yourself. You become a healer. Only when you become a healer, you can channelize the cosmic energy. So it is not meant for others who are coming in person physically. You can transfer this energy to the other person who is in a remote place. He need not be only in Chennai, he need not be only in India. You can send this energy to any part of the world. That is the unique feature of Reiki. Who can learn? Anyone can learn. I told you in the initial part, children can learn. Children above 10, definitely they can learn. At least only thing is, during summer, I used to conduct free meditation class for exclusively for children from 10 to 15. Senior citizen, again, free meditation class, meditation course, that too, when they come, they know how to, it is not Reiki, how to relax the mind, how to relax the body. If the children learn this sort of meditation, they can perform much, much better than what they have been doing. But this is divine, with the divine power, their mind power increases, their brain power increases, their concentration power increases, their memory power increases, they become more intelligent. With that idea only, I am trying to catch people, children from 10 to 15, definitely their performance will be much better. I have been doing this for the past so many years during summer vacation. Seniors also, I have told you in the earlier part, senior, you need not waste your time by sitting at home and watching TV and gossiping with somebody. You learn this one, you can help the society. See, the pleasure of doing Reiki is when somebody comes with sickness. When you heal somebody, next day he comes and says, I am much better. For the past 10 years, I have been spending sleepless night without this puff. I was not able to sleep. Yesterday I had very good sleep. How happy you are. That happiness you cannot derive even if you spend 1 lakh, 1 crore. You have seen crores have been spent in that resort. Once they come out, they are no more happy. But this happiness is coming from the mind of the person who is enjoying Reiki. Reiki actually goes to the mind and the physical body, it reaches the root cause of the person. So, you derive happiness by helping the others, by giving 100 rupees, 200 rupees, or the food when in the form of alms. That is not going to help. But when you help the person who is suffering from chronic disease, the person when he comes and says, when you get the feedback, that amount of pleasure you are getting, you can only experience only when you run Reiki. These are the chakras. Chakras have got their own name. Each chakra has got its own location. Just like our human body has got its own organs in a particular place. Whether you are Indian, American or Chinese, all the organs, all of us are human beings. All of us are receiving the, breathing the same energy. So, that energy is available in abundance in cosmos. The same energy passes through the auric body, passes through each and every chakra. That is the Sahasrara chakra. Each chakra has got its own name. See, these are all Sanskrit names. That itself is an indication. This has got, Sanskrit is our Indian language. This itself is an indication. This actually has got an origin. Only thing is, we didn't promote this one. One person came from Japan. He actually revived this system. He has given a new name called Reiki. But only thing is, nobody is able to translate these terms, Sanskrit term. They are existing as they are. Sahasrara chakra, Agni chakra, விஷுத்த சக்கர, அநாகத்த சக்கர, மணிப்புர, சுவாதிஷ்டான, மூலதர சக்கர. 7 மேஜர் சக்கராஸ் ஆர் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிள் ஃபார் அவர் ஹெல்த் அண்ட் ஆல்சோ டிசீசஸ். இஃப் ஒன் சக்கர டசன்ட் ஃபங்க்ஷன் ப்ராப்பர்லி, டிசீஸ். இஃப் ஆல் தி சக்ரட் 7 சக்கராஸ் ஆர் இன் ஹார்மனி, வி ஆர் இன் குட் ஹெல்த். ஆஸ் சிம்பிள் ஆஸ் தட். பட் ஒன்லி திங் இஸ், லேர்னிங் இஸ் இன் ஒன் டே. ஃபஸ்ட் ஸ்டேஜ் யூ ஆர் கோயிங் டு லேர்ன் அபவுட் தி சக்ரா, யூ ஆர் கோயிங் டு லேர்ன் அபவுட் தி ஃபிசிக்கல் ஆரிக் பாடி, யூ ஆர் கோயிங் டு லேர்ன் தி யூ வில் பி டோல்ட் அபவுட் தி லிங்க் பிட்வீன் தி சக்ரா அண்ட் தி endocrine organ, how you can diagnose, how you can scan the chakra, how you can talk to the patient and find out what the problem is. It's so easy. I start the class without any knowledge of Reiki. People are coming to my class on the same day evening. I say start practicing, they are practicing. People, one lady who has learned Reiki from me, her daughter actually had hepatitis. After learning the first, after going through the first stage, when that girl, her daughter fell sick, she treated her. Within 3 days, the jaundice just vanished. She didn't take her to the any hospital. Just, it is miracles do happen. Only thing is, you must learn, experience, then you will enjoy your life. That is the purpose of Reiki. You must know how, why you are existing, how you can enjoy day-to-day life. I thank all of you for patient listening. Benefits of Reiki: you need not send any patient to any diagnostic test, nor you can prescribe any medicine. Even if you are a doctor, you need not prescribe. But there are so many doctors who have learned from me, and I am asking them not to abandon that one. You combine Reiki with your system of medicine. What is that you want? You want fast recovery. Fast recovery comes in no time. So I am asking physiotherapists, paramedical staff, doctors to learn Reiki so that the society need not suffer from any disease. Entire society will be healthy. India should be healthy. People are asking me, are you going abroad? I said, I am not going abroad. I want all Indians to be safe and healthy. It is only for that I am sticking on to India. I am trying to promote this one. Thank you. I will ask you to keep your hand like this. This is called Chin Mudra. Though you are sitting here, your mind can go anywhere. So this is called, to some extent, to control our mind, we are just, this is called Chin Mudra. That is, this is the thumb, tip of the thumb. Allow the tip of the index finger to press or come in contact with the tip of the thumb. Tip of the index finger should touch the tip of the thumb. This, the other three fingers are stretched like this. This is called Chin Mudra. To some extent, it can control your mind. Then I am just going to explain what I am expecting from you. I will ask you to close your eyes, raise your eyeballs up and concentrate on the center of your forehead. This is where our third eye is present. Through the third eye, I will ask you to see the space. Now this space appears as a mere vacant space. This is not vacant space. It is filled with enormous number of cosmic energy. Once you concentrate through your inner eye, the space, this you can visualize the space getting filled with enormous number of bright white particles. What are the, from where do you get these white particles? We in India, we call sun as sun god. What you see is the white light. That white light will be in the, you can visualize in the form of particles, energy particles. These energy particles only we are breathing. So I will ask you to concentrate on these particles. I will ask you to allow these particles to condense to form a bright beam of light. I will ask you to concentrate on the bright beam of light. When I say breathe in, take a deep breath and allow this abdomen to expand as much as possible. I will give minimum time because some of you may not be able to retain for a long time, minimum time. Then I will not say breathe out. Instead of that, I will just say Om. Om, from where does it come? I already told you, Mooladhara Chakra is connected to the Mother Earth. You have heard of Big Bang theory from the primordial sound called Om. The entire universe is supposed to have been evolved. That actually you are going to chant now. So first I will ask you to concentrate on the white light. Allow the abdomen to expand. Now you are going to, I will start chanting Om. When is this chanting Om synchronizes with exhaling. Inhaling white light, abdomen expands. Then after few seconds I start chanting Om. When I start chanting Om, you also start chanting Om. Om, how does it help? Om comes from the mother in the form of a primordial sound. It just goes up, 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 mixes with the energy, cosmic energy which is already there in the chest and abdomen. When you start chanting Om loudly, it goes to the auric body. Without your knowledge, your aura, all of us are born with the aura, this energy goes to the aura. So aura also is getting filled with the two sources of energy, white light and also sound energy. This fills up the energy, this actually fills up the auric body. Then for few seconds or for few minutes, I'll just do this one, inhale and now stand. You have to follow me. Then by this the mind relaxes, then the physical body has to relax. For the physical body to relax, you take this energy from the abdomen and chest to the different parts of the body. I am not going to use the technical term, just say head, face, sensory organs, etc., etc. Then you just follow these parts. As you go on, follow, as I enumerate these parts, the energy, as you concentrate on these parts, the energy without your knowledge reaches each and every part of your physical body. Physical body and mind will relax. Then I will give you some time. I will just say, when I talk hereafter, you should not open your eyes. I just say, stretch your palms, then rub the palms against each other. Then, I have already told you are your own doctor. If you have any problem, you keep your, just rub the palms against each other, keep your hand like this. Supposing you have lower abdomen pain, keep your hand like this. Supposing you have got stomach pain, supposing you have headache. Only thing is, you don't concentrate on your headache. Just concentrate only on the palm. As long as you concentrate on the palm, the energy just flows smoothly, reaches the root cause of your problem. If you don't have any problem, just keep your eyes, keep your palm on the eyes, that's all. This will relax the physical body and mind. Then we are in an environment which is polluted. Everywhere there is what we hear as terrorism. Nobody is in peace. But we can pray for the global peace also. Even for Chennai, I was not sure whether I would be able to reach this place today. I was just concentrating, what is the have you got any problem here? Because I already fixed this one, whether to postpone it or to conduct this one, I was not sure. Because yesterday you know what has happened. So, I wanted to make sure. So, for this peace in Chennai, India and global peace. What is global? Globe is in the form of a globe like this. Okay. So, at the end of this, I just say, visualize a globe between your palm. Bring these two palms together, apart like this. Concentrate only on your palms, but only thing is, visualize the entire universe within your palms, between your palms. Now just I am going to guide you afterwards how we can energize this globe itself. For global peace also we can conduct the meditation now. Are you ready? Don't cross the legs. Keep both the feet grounded. Let us start with a simple prayer, universal prayer. Keep your eyes closed. God, the creator of this universe, please bless me with abundant divine energy. I request the universe to bless me with abundant divine energy. I request my parents to bless me. I request the Mother Earth to bless me. I thank myself because I am capable of receiving this energy. Keep your eyes closed. raise your eyeballs up and concentrate on the center of your forehead. This is where you have got your inner eye. Through the inner eye, just look at the space. As you concentrate on the space, you feel the entire space getting slowly filled with enormous number of dazzling white particles. These are the cosmic energy particles filling up the entire space. Now you are able to visualize these particles. Through the inner eye, you are looking at the energy particles. Now allow these particles to condense to form the bright beam of light. Concentrate only on the beam of light. Allow the beam of light to enter into your chest. Let it enter into the abdomen. Keep your eyes closed. Please don't open your eyes. Now, your mind is totally relaxed. Your chest and abdomen are filled only with the divine energy. To relax the physical body, take the energy from the chest and abdomen to head. The head is covered by a thin skin. That is called scalp. It is slowly relaxing. Now the energy is penetrating the scalp, reach the skull bones, all the bones joined together to form a thick case to protect the brain. The skull is just relaxing, relaxing, relaxing. Now the energy is penetrating the skull, reach the cranial cavity, which accommodates the brain. Now the energy is reaching the brain. The energy just penetrate into the substance of the brain. As it goes deeper, deeper, deeper into the substance of the brain, the entire brain is relaxed. Mind is relaxed, brain also is relaxed. Visualize your face, facial muscles are relaxing. Organs, sensory organs on your face are slowly relaxing, relaxing, relaxing. Visualize the throat, organs in the throat are relaxing. Visualize your chest, organs in the throat, chest region are relaxing. Visualize the upper part of the abdomen, below the chest, above the navel. All the organs here are just relaxing, 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 relaxing. Visualize the lower part of the abdomen below the navel. Organs here are just relaxing. All the internal organs in your main body are totally relaxed. Now visualize the back of your body. Back of the head is relaxing. Neck muscles are relaxing. Chest muscles are relaxing. Lumbar muscles are relaxing. Low back muscles are relaxing. All the muscles in your back are totally relaxed. Now visualize the backbone. All the bones are just relaxing, 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 relaxing. Within the backbone you have got the spinal cord, continuation of the brain, that is also relaxing. Entire back is relaxed. Front and back are relaxed. All the internal organs are also relaxed. Visualize your attachments, right hand, from the shoulder to fingertip, all the muscles in your right hand are just relaxing. Visualize the left hand from the shoulder to fingertip, all the muscles in your left hand are also relaxing. Visualize the legs, right leg, from the hip to toe, all the muscles, massive muscles in your right leg are just relaxing. Visualize the left leg, from the hip to toe, all the massive muscles in your left leg are also relaxing. Hands are relaxed, legs are relaxed. Now visualize your physical body visible to your naked eye, head to foot. Entire physical body is relaxed. Mind is relaxed, physical body also is relaxed. Continue to be in the same state of meditation. Only thing is, you open your palms now. Keep your palms open. Let it face heaven. Now just say this. Let the excess energy flow through my palm. Let the excess energy flow through my palms. Let the excess energy flow through my palms. Now through your inner eye, third eye, concentrate on your palms. As you concentrate on your palms, you feel some vibration in your palms, or something you will feel in the form of heaviness, warmth, something you will feel in your palms. This is the divine energy with which all of us are born. Now you are experiencing the divine power in your own palm. Concentrate only on the vibration which you are experiencing now. Slowly bring the palms together, rub the palms against each other, rub the palms against each other. You feel the warmth. That warmth comes from Sun God. Now you are communicating with the cosmic energy which is outside, created by God. That warmth makes you experience the divine power in yourself. You are your own doctor. If you have any problem, just keep your palms on that particular area. Though you have problem, you know the name of the problem also, forget it. Concentrate only on your palms. As you கான்சென்ட்ரேட் ஒன்லி ஆன் யுவர் பாம்ஸ். Slowly bring your palms down. Now bring the palms in front of you, just in front of your heart. Keep them apart. Now concentrate only on your palms. Still you feel the vibration. Between these two palms, visualize the globe. God, you have created this universe. You have created nature. You have created us human beings. You have created human beings with palms exactly like yours. With which we are supposed to take care of the nature. By ignorance, by greediness, people as parents or as mother, you have to condone us. Bless the entire universe with the pure cosmic energy so that the nature and human beings will live in harmony. Let all the human beings created by you love each other. Protect them from any more calamities. Bless them with kindness, love, and universal energy. Now concentrate on the globe. Visualize white light coming from heaven, embracing the universe, penetrating the globe, filling up the entire globe. God is blessing the entire globe now. There is harmony between the human beings and the nature. Everything in this universe created by the Creator. God, let this peace prevail forever. I thank you for blessing the universe, for blessing me with abundant divine energy. I thank the universe.